Here's another example of a problem that we found that's kind of layer 3 related. VPN and L2TP tunnels. Now, a VPN and an L2TP tunnel are there, and they're basically layer 7 services, where it takes in a layer 3 packet, repackages it, and then puts it in another layer 3 environment. So the don't fragment bit, which we use in IP at layer 3 to tell routers not to break up packets, that is not respected when it gets to a layer 7 device acting as a VPN concentrator or an L2TP tunnel. Those are actually layer 7 type devices which do tunneling for us or some other function. And if you want to call it something other than layer 7, it's an application, so that's why I call it layer 7. You could call it a layer 4. But in any event, it's a tunnel going through your network. Now, when your packet leaves your station, it's 1500 bytes at maximum, and that's called a maximum transmission unit, or MTU. That is the size of the payload at the data link layer that the packet exiting your machine goes out. Now, that 1500 byte packet, as you can see here, travels out of the client, goes into your network, it hits a tunnel device, like let's just say an L2TP tunnel. That L2TP tunnel then takes that 1500 byte packet, and it has to put that 1500 byte packets, but it still has that 1500 byte MTU. It can't make a packet larger than 1500 bytes. So what it does is it takes your 1500 byte packet and it breaks it up into two packets, a large packet and then a smaller packet, and then puts the tunnel overhead on there so that it can go across the network. And then at the other end of the tunnel then collapses that packet and lets go of your original packet, pretty much the way that you let it go outside of your particular machine. So again, we start out with a 1500, we go in, we have a 1400 and a 100, and then it comes back out of the other side of the tunnel and it comes back to 1500. Now, what happens is you're getting the 2-for-1 blue light special here. You're getting 2-for-1. You're getting two packets on the high packet loss, error-prone internet. And consequently, the effect of that is that you're going to lose more packets. And if one of those fragments or those little segments are lost, you're going to have to retransmit both of them. And those intervening devices, being layer 3, are not performing end-to-end retransmission. So it's going to rely on your upper layers on the two ends, typically at layer 4 or layer 7, to retransmit those packets for you, and that can be very costly to your performance. So one of the things that you can do, and by the way, this happens from an internal network where you're sending a 1500 byte MTU packet over to a VPN concentrator. That VPN concentrator is then having to put VPN overhead on top of that 1500 byte. It still has to live with the MTU on the next network of 1500, so it has to break your packets up into two segments. Now, when it does that, obviously you still have this 2-for-1 overhead special. And in some cases, you can end up with packets that get lost, and then consequently your performance plummets when you need it most. Now, when does your device send a 1500 byte packet? It sends a 1500 byte packet when it's got a lot of data to send, when you're doing an FTP, when you're doing something that's a large data transfer, when you really need your network to work. That's when you start getting a 2-for-1 special, when you're doing that FTP download, or you're looking at a big website, or you're looking at a webcast. That's when these problems are going to occur to you. So, in preparation for that, what we do is we lower our MTU, and there's several methods of lowering our MTU so that when our packet, which is at maximum 1500, reaches an L2TP tunnel or it reaches a VPN concentrator, it's already smaller so that you get a 1-for-1 packet ratio. Most of your VPN clients today, actually cut your MTU on all of your communications down to 1300 bytes, so that when it gets to the VPN concentrator, it will automatically not have to get the 2-for-1 blue light special and expose your packets, 2 packets for every 1 packet for potential packet loss on the internet. Now, there are several ways of accomplishing that. Well, all of this stuff works automatically, and the MTU mismatches will get fixed provided you are allowing the ICMP, Internet Control Message Protocol, packets to get from the device and go back to the client or back to the server who sent the packet. Well, unfortunately, today we have firewalls, and our firewalls are blocking the necessary ICMP path discovery packets that normally would manage and make sure you don't get the 2-for-1 blue light special on your own. But because of security constraints, we've turned off ICMP, and so consequently, we have to do what's called end-to-end MTU management of our systems. So it would behoove you to get an analyzer out and to put it at these various locations and find out if you are indeed using ICMP, destination unreachable, path MTU discovery mechanisms effectively, or if in fact your firewalls are dropping those, and understand how this process is working in your particular environment. So what I recommend is out here on these routers on the edge, if you do have and want this to be automatic, you can take your clients, which are out here on your internal network, you can take your first router and you can set the MTU where you do have ICMP, destination unreachable, path MTU discovery packets, where those are allowed inside your normal network, where they are not blocked by a firewall. And what we can do is lower the MTU on the inside link next to the firewall on the router, and then all of this will be automatic by lowering your path MTU on this particular router interface down to 1300. Essentially, every packet that comes through there will automatically get its MTU lowered by path MTU discovery, and then your packets will flow through onto your VPN or onto your L2TP tunnels, already smaller, to go through that trip and get the expanded headers, okay? So this is one of the things that you might want to look for, you might want to understand in your environment so that you know how things are working, and so that if you were ever audited by a technical group, that you would have the answer appropriate to the question for security purposes or what have you. You kind of need to know about path MTU discovery and at every single point along the path what's going on with your MTU size. So, thanks very much for listening, and we'll have more.